Hi, I'm Paul Salmon, and you're about to see a club first, Hawkeye, a video newsletter that takes you behind the scenes of the mighty Hawks. We head into the locker rooms, the gym and rehab. We find out what Crawford and Dutchie get up to when they're not kicking a footy, and we catch up with Dipper and Dermie. You can imagine what those two are like. We've also got a fantastic Samsung competition, so stick around to get competition details. We hope this is the first of many Hawkeye videos, a video produced by the players for you, the supporters. So tell us what you think. And now, let's hear Judge's review of the season so far.
The mid part of the season, I have to say, I am quietly happy with the way we've gone. I believe that when it's considered that we had a very young list to start the season with, and that in some areas we were perceived not to have great strengths, I believe that the development this side has shown and the competitiveness the side's shown has been a real positive from the season. I can't say I'm totally satisfied with the win-loss ratio to date, and it is something that I think and I hope and I believe that we can improve in the second half of the year. But I must say that I am very happy with the direction that we're going in. I'm extremely happy with the development that some of our younger players have made, and I'm very convinced that Hawthorn Football Club is heading in the right direction for the future. Coming into the season, I would have thought that, you know, I believe that we could make the eight, and as a group, as a match committee and as a group of players, we discussed the fact that we believe we could play off in the finals this year. I don't think that that's out of the question yet, and I'm not prepared to concede it until it's mathematically impossible that we can get there. But I'd have to say that I would like to have won a few more games than we have to this current stage. But I believe with the improvement we're showing and the consistency we're showing now with our efforts and our endeavours and our competitiveness, I think we can win more than our share of games in the second part of this season and threaten a position in the eight.
Hi, I'm Tony Woods. In my 4 years at Hawthorn Footy Club, I've been fortunate enough to play with some true champions. Dunstall, Pritchard, Collins, Langford. And now I'm lucky enough to play with our new vice-captain, Nick Holland. Well, I finally managed to track down Dutchie at the local training ground for budding young commandos, astronauts and AFL footballers. So Dutch, looking around me, it's a pretty extensive hard course. Has this been the beginnings of some of those great high marks that we see on the field from you?
Yes, Tony. Any chance I get, I come down here. I work on the high bars, the rocket ships, and just work on my general high marking down here, and the kids help me out. It's fantastic.
Adelaide boy. Now, how long have you been in Melbourne for now?
Coming into my 6th year now, so yeah, almost consider myself a Melbourneite now.
Any sort of tinges of homesickness?
Definitely, I get homesick because I come from a big family, 7 kids in the family, and when I get home and catch up with all them, I sort of think about, you know, it'd be good to be with the family again.
How have you've become vice captain this year, which is a fantastic honour. Have you found that's added any pressure to your game?
Well, it's an extra responsibility, obviously, with the younger side, and being young myself, having to sort of make sure I'm a leader on the field and off the field to the younger guys. So it's, you know, that added responsibility does sort of play on my game a bit, but, you know, I'm grateful to have the honour, and, you know, with Jason and Fish there to learn off, it's fantastic, and Croft's doing so well, so hopefully, now we can be the next leaders of the club.
Now, one of your great passions outside of footy is surfing.
Still struggle a bit with surfing, but I, you know, really enjoy it, and it's a chance to relax as well, get away from football, and you just sit in the waves, let them dictate to you, and then you try and tear them apart.
Okay, Dutch. This is the famous commando course. I've heard heaps about it. Take me through it.
Are you up to it?
Yes.
Let's go.
Oh.
astronauts past this point only.
I'll take you through astronaut school when I return.
Certainly has been a special year for the club, and particularly because we've welcomed back to the fold club legend Robert Dipier Domenico. Now, I thought it was bad playing against this bloke, but really, you should try talking to him.
Dipper. Into space, make it!
How did they get you back involved, and did you jump at the opportunity?
Judge, you asked me to come down, yeah. And just come out for a bit of a run. I enjoy the bit of a run, and it's just great to be involved. You know, one night away for what it's worth, I really enjoy it.
We played against one another so long, and I remember going back to 1983, where you just cleaned me up straight down the middle, mate. Do you remember the game at Optus Oval where you took me out?
No, I don't remember that game, but...
just a diamond. Obviously a diamond does.
Look, I can't remember every bloke I put through, but the ball must have been between you and I. So I'm sure the ball was there somewhere.
It was on my chest.
I remember now, yeah. What a great era that was. I mean, we can just talk about the Essendon and Hawthorn games. Mm. I mean, I remember when you were picked for Victorian side, and Simon Madden and yourself came down to the football club, and you were sitting in our spa at Glenfrey Oval, and
that's
I thought,
right, yeah.
What's he doing in our spa? I really, really hated you boys being in our club, you know?
Yeah, it was, look, the rivalry was intense.
Yeah,
I mean,
great.
On the field, and less so off it. I mean, there was a mutual respect between the clubs. But look, I'm down here at Hawthorn now, and it's been a huge turnaround for me personally. It goes without saying how much the Hawthorn Footy Club means to me now. It must mean an enormous amount to you, and the position where the club is sitting at the moment,
yeah.
And you've spent some weeks now, some months amongst the guys. What sort of a feel have you got for where we're at?
I think where we're at, we're still a very, very young side. I mean, you know, the days I came back, I mean, let's not talk about the past, but, you know, I played under-19s football, seniors, and also reserves, 99 reserve games. I mean, I had guys like Calvin Moore, Peter Knights, Lee Matthews, these sort of people to learn from. And unfortunately, here at the moment, at the club, the experience is yourself and Jason, and that's probably about it, really.
Yeah.
And Judge, obviously, ex-playing, whatever. And some of the young fellas now getting 50, 60 games are still learning about where to get the next kick.
Life outside of football, I mean, we all know about your high profile in the media.
Mm.
You know, a lot of people don't know about the degree you've got behind you and a lot of successful nature of your business away from footy as well.
Yeah, I've got a Brownlow degree, which really not many people have got one of those. And you're a funny boy.
Your Brownlow business card, by the way.
Now, I spent 6 years in the marketing school at Holmes College while I was playing football part-time. And then... I've transferred that into a business called Lyman Direct Solutions. I was involved in the printing business for a while, and now we have a marketing company. We employ 6 people, I'm really enjoying that side of work too, because the thing is, what I learned here at the club about integrity, about the way you represent yourself, and...
obviously not much.
Funny man, yeah. Hey.
But as far as this degree issue is an interesting one, because modern football, players are finding it harder and harder to hold down your 9-to-5 traditional job. So a lot of the guys are in courses.
I still reckon the players can be very lazy too, because it's amazing what you can do in a day. I mean, a lot of us, while we're 18, 20, 25 or whatever, all we want to do is play football. There's nothing wrong with that.
Yeah, yeah.
But really, if you just sit around and wait for training and sit around to play football, you do get mentally tired. Yeah. And you've just got to be able to work on other things. Because one day, as we all know, Paul, I mean, you've had knee injuries, I've had X amount of injuries, whatever.
Facial.
It can actually just finish there and there. Mm. And no one really knows what's going behind the next door, do they? Oh, the kids, Candace is down here. My son's come now for the night. He was born here. He was born at the club, so. And one day, hopefully, he'll be playing here, so.
In this video, we're going to hear from the judge. It's the boss's assessment of every player for the season so far. Here's part one.
Nathan Chapman, one of the players involved in the deal with Brisbane for Brad Scott. Nathan's played at both ends of the ground for us this year, more predominantly as a backman, but he also has also shown some very good form for us when moved forward in some games. Nathan, I'm sure we can expect bigger and better things from him as the year goes on. Daniel Harford, unfortunately Daniel had a late start to the season. Harf, as we all know, is a very gifted player and a player who is very important to Hawthorn Football Club. He's now starting to return to somewhere near his best form, and when he's in that type of form, he's certainly going to trouble opposition sides. Brendan Crummell, unfortunately Brendan's missed a few games with injury this year. Brendan's versatility is one of his great assets. He has displayed some good form forward in the forward line for us. Takes a lot of pressure off Nick Holland when he's playing well forward, but he, again, has had to be pushed back on occasions and do jobs for us back there. Mark Graham, unfortunately Mark also has suffered some injury this year, along with a number of other of our important players, but Mark, who has returned to the side in recent weeks, is really now starting to show the type of form that we expect from him. His versatility, again, like Crummell, is an important asset to our side. Shane Crawford. Shane has had a terrific year for us this year. He's really taken another step as a player. He's taken on the responsibility of one of the vice captains of the team, and his form so far has been excellent. He's played on some of the real big names in the competition and beaten them, which is a great indication of the character of the player we've got in Shane Crawford. Daniel Chick. Daniel's made good development again this year as a player. He's shown an ability this year to play as a backman as well as a forward. He probably found a niche for himself as a forward. When cast into a role in the back line in recent times, he's taken up the challenge very well, and he's taken another step forward as a footballer for Hawthorn Football Club. Tony Woods. Tony's again been one of our most consistent players. He's since he's been at Hawthorn Football Club in the last 4 or 5 years. He's been a notoriously high finisher in our best and fairest. I would think this year would be no exception. He's continued on where he's left off in recent years, playing on big name players and showing a great ability to be able to negate their influence on a game. Nathan Turvey. Nathan has tasted a bit of senior football this year, playing 3 or 4 games. Nathan's an exciting player with his leg speed and also his kicking skills. Nathan's just got to find a little bit more consistency at senior level yet to really cement a spot in the side, but he's shown enough to indicate to us this year that he has a very good future at the football club. Chris Hobbs was our second pick in the 1997 November draft. He has shown good development this year. He's still growing. He's a good sized fellow. He's about 6 foot, 1.5 or 2 in the old terms. Plays as a very well-balanced and skilled halfback flanker midfielder, and he's showing good development at reserves level. He's been close to senior selection on a number of occasions.
1998 is a new era for Hawthorn. Being sponsored by Samsung should see us well into the 21st century. Samsung are the 11th biggest corporation in the world with a huge range of products. Let's give them a workout.
And remember, when you buy Samsung, you're supporting the Hawks.
We are very proud to introduce the Australian Drug Foundation as an official partner of the Hawthorn Football Club. As a parent, drugs and alcohol are a real concern to the future of our children. Whether you want to find out the latest drug information or to talk to someone about a related issue, Drug Info is committed to providing accurate and up-to-date information on drugs and alcohol. You can call Drug Info on 13 1570.
G'day, Shane O here, and I'm here at the set of my new show, Footy Frenzy. Yep, it's my show, and it's going to be starring on Channel 9 every Saturday morning, so stay tuned and make sure you're watching. I suppose being here on Footy Frenzy, you have to be many things. You have to be a singer.
Humphrey Bear! He has lots of best friends everywhere.
You have to be a comedian.
Everything's so small, you can't even see properly.
Turn him around the other way.
To be a computer technician and also a television technical guru. Believe it or not, I'm all of those. We got a message coming out to you. People you don't want to know. There you go, an AFL 98 EA Sports game. See you breathing in the EA feed. Now seems a little more each day. Shane Crawford, and this is Wayne Campbell. He's my partner in crime. We're doing a show called Footy Frenzy. So make sure you watch it. It's going to be Saturday mornings. And welcome to my humble abode. I'll just give you a quick tour. Over here is Wayne Campbell. He's lost a bit of weight. Here's my BMX bike, if you can see that, and all my ski gear for when I go down the snow with Tony Woods. Over here's the kitchen, it's very nice. There you go, see? Footy Frenzy, that's a new TV show, and this is my mug. So everything there, from the phone to down here, we eat a lot of pizzas. We don't really, it's just the show. So there you have it. This is what I do when I'm not playing football, is hanging around the studios and doing Footy Frenzy. Cheers.
Richard Taylor has been one of our really good players for us this year. Richard's form has been excellent. I would think he would be well up in our best and fairest this year, and it's a reflection of the hard work he's done. When you consider that Richard has come back from two knee reconstructions just in just a few years ago, his efforts this year for us have really been something special. Ben Dixon. Ben's really developed well for us as a player this year. He's really now taking a more senior role on the side. His support beside Jason Dunstall has been very good. His marking has really developed as well, and he's a very hard at the ball type character. Aaron Lord has continued on where he left off from last year. Aaron was a runner-up in our best and fairest in 1997, and his 1998 form has been of similar status. He really is an important player because of his tremendous work ethic. He has an ability to play across half forward or through the midfield for us, and his ball-winning capabilities are an extremely important asset to our team. Phil Smith. Phil has yet to play senior football for us this year, but he's probably not far away. He was a good performer in our reserves finals last year, and he had a minor hiccup in the pre-season, which with a stress fracture in his foot, which probably delayed his progress a little bit this year. Nathan Thompson. Nathan has been a credit to himself. Nathan worked very hard over the pre-season to get himself into a good physical shape. He lost a considerable amount of weight, and he's worked very, very hard. He's been rewarded with a couple of games at senior level to this point in the year. Brad Lloyd has had an unfortunate year this year. After showing some very good form early in the year at senior level, he suffered a broken bone in his ankle, which has taken longer to repair than we would like. And that's been a real dampener for the club because he has shown some excellent form in the early games he played at senior level. We expect Brad will be back and playing senior football in the near future. Paul Salmon. Paul, unfortunately, has suffered from a few injury problems this year, not missing games, but actually playing under some duress. His playing form in recent weeks has been on the improve, probably because his body is actually in a slightly better shape than it was earlier in the year. But it's a credit to him that he's managed to play the majority of the games under some duress and still be a valuable contributor to the team. Randall Bone. Randall's hasn't had many opportunities at senior level this year. He's had some small injury problems that have affected his fitness and form. And Randall is a player who's really at the stage in his career at this football club where he needs to get his body right and give himself a chance to play senior football. Hayden Kilmartin was one of our players drafted in the March draft. He's had some exposure at senior level so far this year. He's proven to be a busy player in those games, of small stature but fairly hard and competitive at the ball. He's shown that he can be a handy player for Hawthorn Football Club. Whilst he hasn't played on a regular basis senior level this year, he's shown enough in his opportunities there to make us believe that he's got a future at Hawthorn Football Club. Darren Kepler. Darren's probably playing his best football since 1996 with Hawthorn Football Club. He's didn't have a good year last year with injury problems, but he's now got himself injury free, and his long kicking and ability to use the ball are certainly great assets to us. He's still shown that he's got his good leg speed that we've all come to know.
They're dirty, they stink, they're horrible and they're disgusting. And we wouldn't have it any other way. This is introducing our dirty jumper system, where you, the people out there, get to have the jumpers straight off the players' backs, and they are selling fast. They are walking out the door, and that's a good thing because they do stink. As you see, we've got Daniel Harford here. You get the marks all over him, the sweat, the stench, the whole lot. It's all for you. You get to purchase them.
Hawthorn is the first footy club in Australia to bring in this dirty jumper system. They're available from Hawk's Nest, and believe me, you'll smell them before walking through the doors. You can also place an order on your favourite number for upcoming games. Hawk's Nest at Glen Ferry has been refurbished and is worth a visit. It's full of great Hawks gear. Check out our fantastic range of jackets, tops and accessories. And for our youngest members, there's the Hawks baby gear. Remember, when you buy from the club, your money stays at the club. See you at Hawk's Nest.
Hello world, let's talk about the satisfaction you get from doing a job well. The feeling you get when your hands become tools and make things work again. People who share that pride use Valvoline. All over this great country of ours, thousands of mechanics, people who change their oil themselves, trust in the oils that deliver engine protection that you can depend on. And at a price that'll suit every working Australian. Keep the dream alive with Valvoline. You know what I mean.
You can get it rolling. You can get it going. You can get it feeding a fire. A hard-earned thirst needs a big cold beer. And the best cold beer is Vic. Vic Bitter. It can come at any time. Edition up chow. Or showing them how. Matter of fact, I got it now. Vic Bitter.
Here's your chance to win a video recorder, which has been donated by our club sponsors, Samsung. What we want to know is the very first player that Judgy assessed on this video. To enter the competition, simply write the answer on the back of an envelope along with your name, address and contact phone number. Send your entry to the Samsung VCR Competition Hawthorn Football Club, P.O. Box 52 Hawthorn 3122. Here's a hint, you'll find it right at the beginning. But before you hit rewind, here's the great man himself, Dermot Burton.
So you come up, we get to here, and you might go either side, and it might be, Dipper might break this way because of pressure. So instead of just going to here...
My involvement with the players is trying to be a direct link between board and players. Obviously I have the specialist skills coaching area with the forwards, but as to the role, it's just a link between the board and the players. I don't think there's ever really been that strong link. I think everybody on the team would know that I am just definitively a player's man, and that's the way I take it to the board each time. It's an experience going on the board. It's teaching me a lot. But I'm getting a great deal of satisfaction out of it because, as I said, it is a teaching, learning experience for me. But also my, I suppose you could say, portfolio on the board is to do directly with the team in a training regime. And, you know, taking a few of the young forwards and a few of the older forwards as well. And just running through a few drills. I mean, 10 judges' job is just so broad and varied. That he's asked me if I could help a little bit with expertise in a certain area, so I'm sure Kenny could do it all himself. I've got the utmost of faith in him. I think he's exceptional, but just gives me a chance to be out with the boys, and they seem to enjoy it as well. Obviously, the direction of the club, we would love to be able to utilise Waverley, i.e. stay out here. I think our supporters out in the eastern suburbs really deserve to have something fairly close to them rather than going to town. That's our stance at the moment. We hope to pull that off. It is going to be a difficult battle, but I think Hawthorn's always done very well when placed in front of a difficult hurdle. So that's the direction there. I think our young players, I think if anybody in the league was to look at a team who is on the building cycle, they would have to say Hawthorn is the most blessed with talent. So I think other teams are a little bit envious of us in that regard. So I think, you know, hoping to win up to about 8 games, we'd probably, you know, pull 6 or 7 in the final 11 matches, maybe win one this coming week as well. So, you know, I'm very confident. I wouldn't have come back to the club. I wouldn't want to be part of a team that wasn't moving forward. I do get to a lot of games, but not many Hawthorn games at the moment. I have to watch them on the replay or get the videotape of them during the week. But I probably see on average 3 games of football in person a weekend, and maybe 1 or 2 more on video. So I see a lot of football these days. If I was to tell the supporters I was doing something to keep fit, I'd probably be lying. I just have a run with the boys once a week and a little bit of gym with the boys once a week. And that does me. And I reckon I've earned a rest. I've had enough years of pounding my body up against a brick wall.
Glenfree Oval has been the starting point of a lot of great player epics, both on and off the field. With the advent of modern technology, we've been able to capture some on player cam.
This year's pre-season training camp was up on the Murray, where, as you can see, we were put through our paces.
Who put your moisture on? Got your skin. Too harsh day in the sun.
Day 2, 5 a.m. Not a pretty sight as we prepare for the much feared and talked about Ironman.
Fair to say that the Dutchie hasn't played to the same standards we've expected from him this year, but I see some distinct improvement in his form of latter stages. Nick perhaps has suffered a little bit because of the fact that Jason's had such a great year at full forward, and he's perhaps been bypassed a lot more often to date than he perhaps has in the past 2 years, and in particular last year when Jason didn't play. Craig Trelevin. Craig broke his hand earlier in the year and that set him back a little bit. He's now starting to find his spot back in the side. He's a very important player to us from the point of view that he uses the ball well, and he does set play up very well for us. And we're welcoming him back in the side in the form that he's starting to display now because of that great ability to win the ball and use it so well. Trent Crowe. Trent was our number one pick, draft pick in November. He's an exciting young fellow, Trent. He's just turned 18 years of age. He's had a fair degree of exposure at senior level so far this year, and he's displayed in those games some exciting qualities. Justin Crawford. Justin has played the majority of the year at senior level. He's shown good progress again, a good improvement, and although unfairly compared with his brother Shane at times, Justin has different attributes and a different playing style to Shane. Justin is about to take a step up, I believe, at this football club and take on a more senior type role. We're looking to move him into a more midfield type role and give him a bit more exposure. Luke McCabe has been one of our real improvers this year. Luke, who's been a borderline player for the last couple of years at the club, has played every game at senior level, done some very good negating jobs on important players for the opposition sides, but also shown a very good attacking side to his game. And Luke is really filling an important void for us in the back line this year. Jason Dunstall, what more can you say about Jason? He's been fantastic this year, so much so that I believe he should play again next year. I know it's a bone of contention with him at the moment as to whether he will continue on or not, but certainly in the current form he's been in, I can see no reason why he shouldn't. I mean, his efforts to date under duress with injury have been fantastic, and he continues to lead the club in the manner in which he's led the club for a long, long time. Stephen Lawrence. Stephen started the year in the senior team, lost a bit of form, went back to reserves level and suffered a fracture of the cheekbone, which set him back for 4 or 5 weeks. Stephen has just returned in the last week or two to reserves football, and we're expecting him to be putting his hand up in the very near future to play senior football for us again this year.
It's nice, sir.
G'day Hawthorn supporters, Shane Crawford here, and here I have the magnificent Strathfield product. And as you can see, we've got faxes, we've got phones, we've got everything that you need in your house. And if you are a Hawthorn Strathfield member, you will receive $20 off anything that you may purchase. 15 of that dollars will go into your pocket nicely, and $5 will go to the footy club. So make sure that you get down to Strathfield and buy lots and lots of product. Cheers. Ooh. Yes, Mum, I am looking after myself.
Today, AFL players have to have an extreme level of fitness. Behind every AFL player and every AFL club is a dedicated and knowledgeable fitness staff. We're going to go behind the scenes to talk to our fitness staff, Andrew Phillips, Flipper, and Dave Murray, Muzza.
Flipper established himself as an excellent AFL player with Carlton until he was cut down in his prime with a serious back injury. He's now with the Hawks, overseeing our total fitness program. This includes taking us through the extensive warm-up before each match. Midweek, he's the guy you'll see on the field coordinating our warm-up and any components of fitness training. While this is happening, Muzza is busy in rehab.
I've been in the industry now for 10 years, and it's certainly, as I said, the importance placed on rehabilitation, particularly over the last, say, 5 years, has been intensified. Certainly the coaching staff understand now that it's no longer just flogging players out on the track. It's, as I said, making sure that players individualise the specificity and the actual functional training involved in rehabilitating players is so important now. So you've really got to look at the actual individual player and look at the position that he plays and try and simulate everything in the rehab program to the actual position that he plays out on the football ground.
When Hebe fractured his foot earlier this season, the fitness team designed a specific rehab strategy to get him back on the field as quickly as possible.
It's really a tough one because there's very little physio you can actually do for the actual injury that he's actually had. So he had his foot in a cast for about 10 days. And obviously a lot of the rehab that we've been doing with him has involved a lot of deep water running, a lot of grinder work, a lot of weights. Obviously it's a time now we can actually put on a lot of weight for Mark. He's a key position player, and we've tried to use that as an advantage to us by turning it around and trying to put some poundage on him, which we've been successful doing.
How'd you lose terms? I'm sick of doing push-ups.
Are you ready?
Go.
Good shoot.
The rehab behind the scenes is, you know, you've got a lot of older players now that you really need to nurture, particularly in season. And a bloke like, say, Jason Dunstall really doesn't get out on the track until a Thursday night. So we really have to, and because of the way the fixture's formatted now, there's some weeks where we really only have short recovery. So the actual rehabilitation of players, particularly, as I said, the older players, is so important that we really need to nurture them and to get them up from game to game. And I think it's important to remember that the philosophy behind our rehab sessions is that we try and create that atmosphere where it's actually harder sessions in the actual rehab than it is out on the track.
On our end of season footy trip to the States last year, the fitness team tagged along. On top of partying, they actually tried to do some work.
And we actually visited quite a few NFL clubs and NBA clubs, i.e. Chicago Bulls, Green Bay Packers, San Francisco 49ers, and we actually tapped into all their rehab programs and we brought a lot of their ideas back, keeping in mind that their game is a little bit different than ours, but certainly tried to put into the program the parts that we thought were successful. I really believe that we didn't really bring back too much that was different. Obviously, just how to manage players, but in terms of the actual programs, it really just reinforced that I think the programs that we've got going are successful.
Jonathan Hay. Jonathan's been one of our real improvers this year. He's played far beyond our expectations to date. And that's not to say that we shouldn't be expecting some very big things from him in the future. But Jonathan's really found a niche for himself in the back line this year. And as an 18-year-old, we expect him to be one of the real stars of Hawthorn Football Club in the future. Kane Fraser. Kane's had a taste of senior football again this year. Probably hasn't quite settled into a permanent position in the senior team to date. But he's had a couple of opportunities there, and he's showing some encouraging signs to us. Jade Rawlings. Jade's had a fair taste of senior football again this year. He's a player who, coming into this season, he understood and realised that it was important that he play a fair percentage of senior football this year, and he's now starting to do that. He's settled in the back line more often than not, but we expect with his size and versatility that he can play both as a forward and back for us in the future. Angelo Lekas is one of our real surprise packets for the year. Not a surprise packet so much in that he doesn't have the ability, but he's really taken an enormous step this year in his football development. Angelo's shown an ability to play on some of the league's leading players. Raiden Tallis has found his niche again at senior level. He's probably been a little in and out in recent years, but he's found a niche for himself in the midfield again this year at senior level, and he's proving to be a very important player for us. Very hard at the ball type player, Raiden. Always gets in and under and gets in the thick of the action, and really does set play up well for us because of his endeavours in winning the ball. John Robren. John's developed again this year, I think, as a player, and he's another player who's taken a step forward. He's playing in the key back positions for us, and often he's in a situation where he has to take on more highly credentialed players, but he does the job with a minimum of fuss. John Barker was the other player involved in the Brad Scott deal to Brisbane. John has probably found it difficult this year to find a niche for himself in the side. He is a very athletic player. He has good endurance and has shown an ability to play at both ends of the ground and across the centre line for us. John Hassell has played the majority of the year at senior level for us to date. He hasn't probably quite found his niche for himself yet. He's been used often in roles off the bench, but has proved to be a very valuable player for us when coming off the bench in that role, where his leg speed and his running ability have been used to curtail a very good player for the opposition or to break the game up with his quickness.
It's always a monster year socially for the Hawks, and there's still a couple of big ones to come. The Hawks dinner auction is not only a great chance to pick up some bargains, maybe bid for some fantastic Hawk memorabilia, but also a chance to see the players strut their stuff. The Hawks dinner auction is on August the 8th at the Grand Hyatt in Melbourne, and the cost is $75 a head. And on October the 3rd, there's the Club Champion Dinner at the Palladium Ballroom Crown. That's $85 a head. For bookings, phone 9816 2222. Well, that's it for this edition of Hawkeye. We've had a great time making the video and giving you a bit of insight into what it's really like behind the scenes at the Hawthorn Footy Club. Thanks for your support, and we look forward to seeing you at the games.
It'd be good to be with the family again, but I really like Melbourne. Yes, Mum. I'm looking after myself. G'day, how are you?
We've had a great time. You wouldn't believe the time we've had.
I believe you.
Okay.